कनिपल है।
हेलो,
हेलो,
ऑडिबल है?
हाँ
हाँ
सर, हाँ आपकी आवाज आ रही है, मेरी आवाज आ
सर,
रही है? हाँ,
हाँ बिल्कुल ठीक है सर,
वीडियो, ओके ओके सर,
हाँ वीडियो भी
ओके
कर, ओके थैंक यू सर।
ओके।
पण त्यांनी मा हे पेमेंट पण काय
हेलो हेलो आर यू एबल टू हियर मी
या वेरी मच
ओके
இத மூடிடலாம் கொஞ்சம்
सभी लोगों के लिए मेरा नमस्कार प्रणाम। हम लोग आज एक बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण वेबिनार ऑर्गेनाइज कर रहे हैं जो कि प्लास्टिक वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट रूल और उसमें हुए अमेंडमेंट्स व जनरल कंसेप्ट टेक्नोलॉजी के बारे में व सिंगल यूज प्लास्टिक के यूज के बारे में हम लोग इस वेबिनार में डिस्कशन करेंगे। मैं इस अवसर पर हमारे मुख्य अतिथि महोदय श्री पी नरहरी साहब जो IAS बैच 2001 कैडर MP और सेक्रेटरी MSME गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया है मध्य प्रदेश है उनका मैं हार्दिक अभिनंदन करता हूं सर। और मैं इस अवसर पर आए हुए सभी एक्सपर्ट्स और कनेक्टेड जितने भी इंडस्ट्री इंस्टीट्यूशंस और गवर्नमेंट ऑफिशियल्स और इंडस्ट्रीज के जो हमारे पार्टनर हैं करीब 497 पीपल ने इसमें रजिस्टर्ड कर चुके हैं अभी तक, जिसमें अराउंड 70 इंडस्ट्रीज हैं, गवर्नमेंट ऑफिशियल 80 हैं, बाकी सभी स्टूडेंट्स हैं डिफरेंट यूनिवर्सिटीज और इंस्टीट्यूट से। मैं इस अवसर पर सरस्वती वंदना के साथ इस प्रोग्राम का, क्योंकि भगवान को याद करना हर प्रोग्राम में हम लोग महत्वपूर्ण समझते हैं, उससे स्टार्ट करते हैं। सबसे पहले सरस्वती वंदना। थैंक यू। मैं आदरणीय पी नरहरी साहब से आग्रह करूंगा कि वो इनॉग्रेशन इस प्रोग्राम का अपने अच्छे वचनों और हम लोगों के मार्गदर्शन हेतु शुरुआत की घोषणा करें। पी नरहरी साहब आदरणीय।
सभी को नमस्कार, गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीबॉडी, होप आई एम ऑडिबल।
यस सर, एंड विजिबल
आल्सो। आई एम वेरी हैप्पी टू बी पार्ट ऑफ टुडेज इनॉग्रल नेशनल वेबिनार ऑन प्लास्टिक्स वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट एंड अमेंडमेंट रूल्स एंड इट्स इम्प्लिकेशंस। Central Institute of Petrochemicals Engineering and Technology, CPET, Center for Skilling and Technical Support. CSTS Bhopal is a premier institution under the Department of Chemicals and Petrochemicals, Ministry of Chemicals and Fertilizers, Government of India. CPET Bhopal established in 1988 with the support of Government of MP and Government of India with 50-50 contribution to cater the need of polymer fraternity in and around the region, to cater the need of skilled trained manpower, CAD-CAM design, CNC tools, raw materials, processing, testing and quality control on plastic materials, plastic products, technical consultancy on various projects, taken up development activities in the past many years. CPET's CSTS Bhopal is organizing today this national webinar on Plastic Waste Management Amendment Rules 2021 and its implication, and also to celebrate Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, 75 years of Indian independence, Jan Bhagidari theme. As we are aware that the plastic waste management is one of the key issues to handle solid waste management. The Government of India has made many rules, policies for management of plastic waste generated from different sources. Recently, a new amendment rules in plastic waste management has been notified in August and September 2021. Looking at the importance of the plastic waste management and its implication of government policies, which is much needed. This webinar also gives awareness to avoid the use of single-use plastic in day-to-day life as well. The recent Plastic Waste Management Amendment Rules 2021 also identified single-use plastic items which have low quality and high littering potential will be phased out by 2022. Apart from this, I would like to mention that Government of Madhya Pradesh is also making special efforts in the direction of ensuring the avoidance of single-use plastics, and the Department of Urban Administration and also Rural Development of Departments of Madhya Pradesh have issued detailed orders to this effect as to how the single-use plastic should be avoided in day-to-day life. In the MSME department, we are also propagating and also trying to ensure that the plastic-based issues are also sorted out. And apart from this, to ensure that the said rules and amendments which have been made and the Government of India's efforts in this direction are implemented at all places across all boards is also being ensured by us. As a capacity, in the capacity as chairman of Regional Advisory Committee of CPET, CSTS Bhopal, I congratulate CPET Bhopal for organizing such webinar. I'm very confident that this webinar will be useful for the various plastic industries, institutes, entrepreneurs, students, and general public for awareness about plastic waste management, government rules and policies for management of waste, especially single-use plastic. I wish a grand success to this seminar and assure the Department of MSME, Government of Madhya Pradesh will always support CPET and the industrial fraternity for such programs. All the best.
Thank you, sir, for your kind words and motivating all of us for organizing such events. मैं पुनः धन्यवाद देता हूँ सर और विथ योर परमिशन हम लोग टेक्निकल सेशन की सिर्फ शुरुआत करने जा रहे हैं. थैंक
यू. श्योर, ऑल द बेस्ट. थैंक यू.
थैंक यू सर. थैंक यू वेरी मच. मैं डॉक्टर संदेश कुमार जैन, प्रिंसिपल डायरेक्टर सीपेट भोपाल, इस प्रोग्राम की स्टार्टिंग जो थीम है उस पर मैं अपने विचार व्यक्त कर रहा हूं. मैं इससे पहले सभी जितने भी लोग अभी तक जुड़ चुके हैं उनका पुनः हार्दिक स्वागत करता हूं इस वेबिनार पर. तो यह बताना चाहता हूं कि कुछ लिमिटेड क्वेश्चनर सेंसर क्वेश्चनर भी हम लोग ने रखे हैं, क्वेश्चन आंसर सेशन जो लास्ट में है एज पर शेड्यूल। आप अपने कुछ विचार चैट बॉक्स में भी पूछ सकते हैं हम लोगों से, जिससे कि कंसर्न एक्सपर्ट उसको उस दौरान उसका आंसर दे पाए। अदरवाइज सीपैक को लिख भी सकते हैं भविष्य में। मैं सबसे पहले आपको एक म्यूजिक सुनाना चाहता हूं जो कि सुने और फिर हम उसको स्टार्ट करना चाहते हैं इस प्रोग्राम। ये एक दिस इज अ वेरी डिफरेंट सॉन्ग विच इज रेगुलरली हियर इन एवरी सिटीज मोस्टली इन डिफरेंट लैंग्वेजेस आल्सो एंड इन एमपी दिस इज द वेरी पॉपुलर सॉन्ग इन मॉर्निंग आवर्स व्हेन वी हैव सी लास्ट डिकेड्स ऑलमोस्ट 10-15 इयर्स बैक we are not aware about how our waste is collected in a different way and it is segregated at the source itself. So this popularity awareness in morning hours, if you see door to door, the whole urban development people, नगर निगम पीपुल्स, दे आर कलेक्टिंग जो कि हम लोग का कचरा है घरों का, वी आर सेग्रीगेटिंग आल्सो समटाइम्स, स्टिल दैट अवेयरनेस इज समवेयर लैकिंग, ड्राई वेस्ट एंड वेट वेस्ट। सो कंसीडरिंग विद दिस आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट माय प्रेजेंटेशन व्हिच कंसिस्ट ऑफ द ब्रीफ इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट सिंगल यूज प्लास्टिक्स and then different type of rules which is passing through our government, especially in the gazette form by Government of India and implementing bodies, where we has to act at a different partners in the capacity. So first of all, again, is my slides are visible? Anybody?
Yes, sir, it is visible, sir.
Okay, thank you very much. So, फिर से मैं सभी का स्वागत करता हूं. So, if you talk about the single use plastic, if you know this thing, this is a very simplest way, it is a disposable item. Means it is one time use item. Use and throw items, so many definitions are there, but generally it is the material or ultimately product which is used only for one time use and used only for the intended purpose, which is a general definition. So, and of course many of these are recycled. So if you see few items which also affect the environmental adversely and their utility also limited, and because of unorganized littering we are facing environmental problems. So there are few items which categorize by Government of India and especially urban development departments at the state levels, which has to be used, has to be avoided with a proper mechanism So some of these are carry bags, which everybody knows, one-time packaging, food packaging items, especially bottles, PET bottles, which is less than 1 liter, straws, container, cups and cutlery, earbuds, flex banner. So to avoid the use of single-use plastic, which affect the global, and this is also a global concern at present. If you see this slide, you can find how it is affecting the environment because of improper littering. And we are not having that type of collecting system earlier, but nowadays you find it, the clean environment, slowly, slowly we are upgrading our ethical way of disposal, and at the same time, the activeness of the urban bodies in this line. So I thanks to all the stakeholders who are definitely a part of this chain and making India in a very clean drive. And ultimately, we are celebrating this Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav program in a very humanity way and very large way in CPET as well as in India level. Some of the items which is categorized recently by Government of India, where we should do not use disposal of single plastic items like thermocol, polystyrene, other name, made of like cutlery, including plates, cups, glasses, forks, spoon, knives, trays, straws, stirrer, and you mostly use for serving eatable or drinking purpose. So these are the items. Definitely one another person is definitely using one time. If you are going to the fast food center, they will give you plate and cutlery. So that is the one time use. So ultimately, we can avoid that type of things in a simplest way. So use of these items in the primary way we have to avoid. Similarly, decoration, where we are using the plastic flags also. And if it is a national flag, then we have to take much more precautions. And other way, we have to discourage another category of using plastic carry bags, artificial plastic flowers also, PET bottles, especially less than 1 liter, plastic holders, and any other plastic material which for which any alternative is adjusted. So likewise, initially, this is the plan that initial level, Government of India thinking the A category should be avoided by 2022, so that use can be minimized. We cannot say it should be zero, but it should be very much minimized. If you talk about recycling plastics in India, so few items are visible here, like in through PET bottle, we are making some value-added products like ready-made garments, apparels. Through milk pouches, we are going to make, or already existing, some Barsati films, woven sacks, especially used for various applications, food grains or other fertilizers or maybe cement, all these areas. So when they are using, because that is also one time use mostly, so we are making Nivar Patti, especially for the rural area. This type of materials are going to be used for their beds. Similarly, battery cases we are using to develop further after recycling the luggages, suitcases, you can say. Plastic carry bag, that is the main item which is giving a lot of impact on the environmental issues. Through that, we are making different type of mats. And one simple, because this is a very glimpse of plastic products, where like PVC pipe, we are making the shoes. Like there are many other. Now, this is the basic background which I wanted to give, how we can motivate our own, if you are working in an organization, our own people, if you are working in education institute, your own students or researcher, or if you are working in the office, so you can avoid that type of single use plastics. So that the overall government policy has to be placed as per the norms, as per the time schedule given, which I am going to talk in these further slides. Plastic Waste Management Rule 2016 was placed in March 2016. Later on, in March 2018, few amendments has come, and recently, considering the SUP, single use plastic and other points, Government of India recently amended the rule in the month of August and just recently in September. So in that way, I am just going to highlight only the change points. First, I will give you the scenario of 2016, the basic rules which has been formed. Because earlier it was solid waste management rule, and slowly it has been converted into the plastic waste management rules in 2016. So 2016 rules speaks about the title, the application. In bracket, if you see the rules numbers also given, I am not going to read because the time is also short. Definitions of different terminology, some conditions, then concept of plastic waste management overall, and ultimately the responsibilities of local bodies also identified in that rule. The responsibility of Gram Panchayat in rural area, it has been identified. Responsibility of waste generator means as an individual, as a person, when we are using the material or products. So our responsibility is what to segregate at source, and properly we can make it dry waste and wet waste. Then another one, extended producer responsibility. Under that, responsibility of producer, importers and brand owners, where it has been involved that the concern manufacturer of these products should also hold the responsibility for its waste management and other applications. Then some, when we are talking about recycling, we are also talking about biodegradation of plastic, especially the compostable plastic materials. So that protocol also mentioned. Then marking and labeling, how to mark. It may be only for the single use, or it may be as per the different norms of Bureau of Indian Standard or ISO norms. Then authority, who is having authority for the implementation part. Then how the local bodies like in MP, pollution control boards in different states, registration of producer or as a recycler or manufacturer, these are the guidelines. The responsibility of retailers and street vendors. Then some pricing policy of carry bags. Then overall, there was a state level monitoring committee was fixed. There are so many members, around 10 to 12 members has been identified. And finally, the reports, how in the different formats. These are the general content of rules 2016. Now we are talking about amendments. So the first amendment, which has been notified by Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change notification on 18 March 2018, then again on 27/3/2018, and recently on 21/12/8 August and 17/9. So these are amendments. Now, what are the amendments has been done in 2018? I will just leave to tell you. They have inserted the rule number 3 after clause A, that alternate use means use of material for a purpose other than for which it was conceived. So after clause G, they have introduced energy recovery, means energy recovery from waste. So these are the some terminology they have used, they have added in that one. Then similarly, rule number 9 and sub rule 3, this is I am talking about 2018, the manufacture and use of non-recyclable multi-layer plastic definition. That part is cut and they use the green one, which is multi-layer plastic, which is non-recyclable or non-energy recovery or with no alternate use. So this is the phasing out period has been given 2 years' time. Then in rule, the whole rule and sub-rule has been substituted in rule number 13 by the notification which has been given here. The every producer or brand owners sell for the purpose of registration. So some registration policy format they have changed here, and rule 15 is emitted from there. So I think rule 15 was, if you see here, that was pricing of carry bags. So that was clearly omitted from in rule 2018 when it has been modified. Recently, in 2021, two amendments has come where the green line, which has been shown in the slide, is the corrected one, means the inserted one, the new policy. So if you read here, the rule number 2, sub rule number 1, where these rules shall apply to every waste generator, local body, gram panchayat, manufacturer, importers, brand owners. This has been added after importers, brand owner, plastic producer, recycler or co-processor. So they have added the horizon of what are the means this rule shall be applied to whom. Earlier it was up to importers. Similarly, in rule number 3, some definition has been added, like for non-woven plastic bag also be added here, where non-woven bag, plastic bag made up of plastic sheets or bag structure fabric or entangled plastic fibers or filaments and by perforating films bonded together by mechanically or thermal means or chemical means, and the non-woven fabric means a flat or tough porous sheet. Because sometimes it is a confusion when we are means what type of material in which form as a it should be acceptable for the use as a storage or what are the other applications. So they have classified non-woven plastic bags also here. Then this is another rule which has been inserted in clause Q of rule number 3, where plastic waste processing has been classified. Similarly, in clause 5, single-use plastic commodities means a plastic item intended to be used once for same purpose before being disposed or recycled. So this is the general terminology it has been used for plastic commodity. Thermoset plastic means another one, a plastic which becomes irreversibly rigid when heated and hence cannot be remolded into desired shape. Then thermoplastics, that definition they have, it has been added as per rule 2 and 3. Something more, sorry. In rule 4, they have added here after importer stocking, which has been deleted, they use importer stocking, comma, deke, okay, distribution sale and carry bags. So this has been added. Then rule number 1, the full paragraph has been added for carry bags. Here I will just tell you that there are further guidelines are there for this has been taken in the further rule, where carry bag made up of recycled plastic or product. Earlier it was not permitted for storing, carrying, dispensing, packaging for the ready to eat material or drinking food stuff. Now, as per amendment in September, just recently, it has been permitted to use for storing, carrying, this means recycled plastic I am talking, or products, storing, carrying, dispensing, packing, ready to eat or drinking foodstuff subjected to notification of appropriate standards and regulation under the Food Safety and Standard Act 2016, by the Food and Safety Standard. So now it has been permitted, unless until you are fulfilling these norms of food safety and standards. So recycled carry bag is permitted to use for food application, food storage applications. This is also very, very important rule, where you know that carry bags earlier in 2016, it was permitted for only 50 micron thickness limit. Now it has been permitted with effective from 39/2021, means already one day is over. Less than 75 micron should not be used. So the carry bag size which has been used for virgin or recycled plastic material should not be used less than 75 micron with effective from 39/2021. So this rule is now in place. And 31/12/2022, the same will be going to be implemented as 120 micron. So this is the way the industrial scenario has to going to be changed. User who is using, trader or other people concerned, organization who is procuring, they have to see that. And even as a public who is going to be used, please assure that your carry bags should not be used less than 75. Once you are informing the concerned authority, it will be useful so that this rule can be placed across the nation in a very means it should be streamlined the activities. So this is very important. Similarly, insertion of sub rule 1 for clause H, where only some green, if you are able to see, some commodity word has been used. Okay. Similarly, now one more clause has been added in rule 1 as a J, non-woven plastic carry bag shall not be less than 60 GSM, that means 60 gram per square meter. So in that way, it has to be used, the non-woven plastic carry bags. This rule 4 for import, manufacturer, stock, distribution is totally revamped and it has been placed and it is going to be implemented with effect from 1st July 2022, where the manufacturer, import, stocking, distribution, sale and use of following single-use plastic, which we have, I have already started with this, including polystyrene and expanded polystyrene commodities, shall be prohibited with effective from 1st July 2022. So that means, what are the single-use plastic we are using made up of this material? It should be start avoiding. So that's why we are telling it should be avoid to use a single-use plastic, which I have shown in very first slide, where this the material was also involved for manufacturing. So this is, government has given the time up to 1st July 2022. Later on, as per implementation policy, definitely the action are going to be initiated. Another one, the earbuds, the plastic sticks for balloons, plastic flags, candy sticks, ice cream sticks, and polystyrene thermocol for decoration. B, plates, cups, glasses, cutlery such as fork, spoon, knife, straw, trays, wrapping or packaging films around sweet boxes, because sweet boxes, we know they are wrapping and packing, invitation cards, cigarette packets, plastics or PVC banners less than 100 micron stirrers. So these are again has been also included under the category of single use plastic. Then rule number 3 and 4, after rule 2, this has to be placed. The provision of sub rule 2B shall not apply to commodity made up, means whatever we have talked here 2B, earlier it should not be used for, means if you are able to make these product in compostable plastic, then definitely you can go ahead with your manufacturing and use also. So this is the clarification. Then fourth one, any notification provision the manufacturer import, stocking, distribution, sale and use of carry bag, plastic seats or like or cover made up of plastic seats and multi-layer packaging and single-use plastic including polystyrene and expanded polystyrene commodities used after this notification shall come into force after the expiry of 10 years from the date of publication. Means other plastic which is notified here to be used, that time limit they have given after expiry of 10 years from the date of its publication, means the March 2021 and amendment in recently has come, that means August and September. So that means September onwards. Then very fine corrections in rule number 5, where earlier the solid waste management rule 2000 was placed, as I have told. So it has been used as 2016 as a plastic waste management rule. Then similarly, insertion in rule 6, the responsibility of local bodies, it has been added, ensuring that the provision of these rules as amended are adhered to. So the local bodies should also take further responsibility that all their market, all their selling and trading points, all the manufacturing points, they should adhere to this rule. Then similarly, rule number 7 also added that the provision of these rules as amended are adhered to, especially in the Gram Panchayat level and other level also, local bodies and Gram Panchayat level. Then another rule number 9, in the sub rule number 1, it has been included as per guidelines issued under the rules from time to time. Means the responsibility, the producer within a period of 6 months from the date of publication of these rules shall work out the modalities or waste collection mechanism. So they are talking about the expanded producer responsibility there. They should also update the information. And as they can modify their system of even distribution, when they are a part of collection mechanism also, they can involve the people in such a way they should be trained properly and they should understand the latest guidelines. Just a minute, please. The next rule, number 11, where the word in the clause number, clause marking and labeling, it has been added, plastic carry bags, plastic packaging also. Now word has been added for plastic packaging or any type of packaging. And multi-layer packaging already was there. Then similarly, A, subclause A, name, registration, number of manufacturer. Earlier it was only manufacturer. Even now producer or brand owner can also write their names and thickness in case of carry bag ke liye thickness bhi mention karna hai and plastic packaging used by the brand owners. Yadi kisi ke upar plastic packaging bhi use kara hai brand owner ne ek aur, to us par bhi aapko same regulation is going to be applied. Then similarly, name and registration number of the manufacturer in case of MLPs, excluding MLP used for imported goods. Okay, so this is the clause. So it has been given excluding but for the imported goods. So that you have to understand. Similarly, name and certificate number of the producer. So this number is generally given by the local controlling body, especially like pollution control board, where they are getting registered. So that type of number can be given. Or if it is coming under the BIS norms, so as per the BIS policy, you have to place your registration number. Now, rule number 12. where only few words they have added, that is restriction or prohibition on use of plastic carry bag, especially in the inner territory urban development of the state. So in that way, restriction or prohibition on use of plastic carry bag. So once we are start restricting or prohibiting, then only we can achieve the deadline of July 2022, especially for the carry bag. Now another rule which is 2021 has been modified, which is rule number 30, where a pollution control committee of the union territory concerned or the central pollution control board, as the case earlier it was the responsibility of state pollution control board in the committee, but now they have added CPCB also in that, so that they can be part of the board even in the union territory. And just to wish to inform you that BIS, Bureau of Indian Standard, also formulated some guidelines for recovery and recycling of plastic waste. Recently it has been modified in 2016, and another one in 2010 revised, where waste and its overall design concept has been guided in that way. So now I have talked about all plastic waste management rules which has been recently modified, and I request sincerely to all the connected people who are as a monitoring agency they are connected, or as a urban bodies they are connected, or as a industry partner you have connected, so and as a user department you have connected, and general students and other institutional people, that with all the support of the overall people, then only we can achieve this goal which has been mentioned, and time to time it is getting implemented by the different regulations. So I sincerely request to all of you, please support in a big way to implement such rules at national level and your level also. Thank you. Now I am talking about plastic waste management concept and technology, which has recently I have come across through a report also. Some data we have taken from that report. In 35 states or union territories, in 2019 and 2020, approximately 34,69,780 tons per annum. So this is the plastic waste is generation. Just for your information, for students especially who are connected, that any solid waste which is door to door, which has been collected by the different bodies, especially local Nagar Nigam or Nagar Palika or Gram Panchayat people, generally it has been observed that around 8% or 9% maximum it is the plastic waste which is in different forms, especially as a general users of carry bag. I am requesting all of you, please don't throw your carry bags by putting the food items inside there. So the waste which is generated as a food should not use any plastic carry bag. So this type of oath you can take as a student, so that you can implement in your house, so that many animals which are going to be eat that food somewhere, that should be not create any problems. And similarly, we should properly segregate the material at our house itself as a different dustbin we can use, which is already educated since last more than 10 years. So I just wanted to give the just scenario state wise, where generation in Maharashtra is 13% of plastic waste overall. Tamil Nadu is 12%. Gujarat is 12%, almost equal. West Bengal is 9%. Karnataka is 9%. Telangana 7%. Delhi, Indian Territory 7%. UP, big state, but 6%. Haryana 4%, Kerala 3-4%, MP again a big state 3%, Punjab 3%, and others 11%. So this is the general scenario. Then per capita based generation, where you can see the maximum is 2500 gram per year. This is the plastic based per capita generation per person. But if you see, because Goa is having limited population, so overall per capita will be more. It is somewhere around 12,000 gram per year. So this is the general information which we can share also. I cannot read because of the shortage of time. Then one case study we have taken it, which is for related to MP, where plastic recycling has been collected around 74,000, co-processing they have used, and complete ban they have implemented, but it has been imposed, not implemented. So likewise, many good points. Similarly, if you see, around 60% of India plastic waste is recycled or recycled in 1920 as per that report, and approximately 15,342 tons per every day was collected. The policy or sustainability of waste, we are having four major options. Either we can reduce, which we are urging to you, for single-use plastic. We can reuse. It is happening in many houses, many places, government department also. Otherwise, we are recycling. And final option is disposal, or finally, it is an incineration in that way. So these are the few environmental issues which has been, by mostly through single-use plastic, which has been we are feeling and we are seeing the scenario. If you see, the number of organized recycling units in India is around 100 plus 42 PET recycling. Unorganized sector is very big in recycling. It is almost 10,000 plus. And of course, this is given to more manpower, around more than 1 lakh. And in that, indirect employment is for around 1 lakh. For the including the waste rag pickers also, almost 100% rigid plastic waste is recycled. More than 90% PET bottles waste is recycled. And similarly, we are permitting for feedstock recycling, that means chemical recycling, very few, and co-processing in cement plants, around 300 kilotons. So like that, and some part we are using for the, especially where government of India is also taking the interest, or state government, to make the bituminous road by in the construction by means of plastic waste they are using. This already I have told you, where recovery landfill finally, that is the disposal, this thing. If you see, the most beneficial is prevention and reduction. We have to minimize the incineration process in that way, because of unhygienic way we are incinerating the plastic materials. And similarly, when the latest scenario we are using and forming the circular, it is useful for the circular economy. So if you see the linear economy, where take, make, use, and finally it is waste. But in recycling economy, we can see in between take, make, then recycling, then again use, then it is going to finally waste. But in circular economy, if you see take, make, then recycling or return, or sometime after use also waste is getting recycling. And so finally, overall, the economy is regulating in a circular way. So this is the most common system which is adopted worldwide now. It is a circular economy in the recycling of, especially for the plastic waste or other waste also. If you see, the major waste of municipal based or industrial based or littering by nature, the three methodology, mechanical recycling, chemical recycling and biological or biotech recycling, composting, where the composting is the major phenomena. So if you talk about mechanical recycling, we have collection, sorting, shredding, cleaning, melting and refusing. So this is the general steps. And finally, through a process like injection molding product, you can make it through injection molded or extrusion. You can make the extruded products, as we I have shown in very early. Then chemical recycling, we have defined hydrocarbons. We are in the form in petrochemicals. Through that, we are making the monomers, then polymers, then plastic products, finally, and post-consumer recovery. So in that way, we are totally modifying the chemical structure and we are using for the next material. Just wait. Similarly, biological recycling, which is again a circular plastic economy, this is more prominent at present. Then we, the ultimate base, which is no useful for further recycling, mostly we are using for the cement plants at present as a kiln. Then some environmental policies which has been code of practice, everybody I think aware, we are putting a mark on our product with a recycling logo, PET, SDP, PVC, number 3, 4 LDP, 5 PP, 6 polystyrene, 7 is others. So as per the IS 14534 2016 guidelines, this is the code. Some plastic based initiative taken by CPET. CPET is organizing various type of awareness programs and to you to avoid the use of single use plastic like this. Then some skill development program we are having NSPF for those. Then some technical support services for execution of the plastic waste management plant. Transfer of technology, especially the e-based, we have already done. And taking a lot of R&D products, R&D projects, sponsored projects from government agency. Some few glimpses of photographs where we are organizing. Then we are having two exclusively facilities for plastic waste management center at Guwahati, started in 2019. And in 2018, we have started the e-waste recycling unit at LARPM Bhubaneswar. And to be stood from to promote the recycling symbol, in 2019, we have formed, celebrate 50th Golden Jubilee, where we have formed the human chain standing on the recycling logo, and around 3,373 people were standing. It was a record also. And these are few webinars recently we have conducted at different places. Honorable PM has also announced during our Jaipur seminar, inauguration of building. Thank you. For more questions, you can ask during question answer session also, and you can write to cpet.bhopal@gmail.com. So thank you very much, all of you, once again. Now I am going to invite Professor Dr. Mangalam Balasubramanian, who is founder and managing trustee of Exnora Green Pamal Chennai. She has grown her career from Allahabad Agriculture College and taken a lot of initiative for multinational organization for bioelectric projects. She is also conducting environmental impact assessment. Presently, she is under the leadership position in Exnora Green Pamal, which is again working on the solid waste management, and award winning in organization in that line. So I request madam to start your presentation and discuss if anything in question answer sessions. Madam Mangala, please.
So, I have been associated with CPET for more than 15 years. Am I audible?
Yes, yes, madam, very good.
I am really honored to be at this session. I don't have a PowerPoint presentation, but I would like to share my humble experiences working in solid waste management for the last 30 years, starting from 1991, even before the MSW rules came into force. So I have seen MSW rules 2000, then after that plastic waste management rules and many of the amendments. Now recently in August, there's a lot of amendments in plastic waste management rules. What I'm going to really discuss now is we have a very good written rules. As a person who is really involved in solid waste management, I would like to share with you some of the field realities, ground realities, what we are facing, which would really pave way that we could really take this, you know, all these rules to really to reach to all those who are involved in solid waste management implementation, collection, to processing, and finally to the disposal. Friends, we all know that we have really learned in our history that we know about our, you know, Stone Age, Iron Age, and then Golden Age, Gupta's period. But we know that now we are in garbage, out of which now plastic is really a very big, you know, problem. Every one of us is facing how to really solve the problem. When we see problem, I always would like to really turn it as an opportunity. If you really see our India, we are holding 7th position in area-wise and 2nd position in population-wise. At this rate, with all the industrialization, urbanization, and our change of living style, our volume of waste is going to be really tripled and quadrupled, both in volume and value. So what is my slogan here is, we need to really take all these challenges into opportunities. Then only we can really adhere to all these amendments, what we have really, you know, talking about. So nicely you have described all the rules clause by. If all those rules and clauses have to be really adhered to, I think we need to really be ready to really take the challenge. Impossible to possible. Challenges to opportunity. And throw away culture to evolving eco-friendly alternatives. And all those things should have a reliability, quality, as well as sustainability. Anything what we do, either recycle, upcycle, or downcycle, it needs to really have a research backup. For which I think we are very, very thankful that SIPET, because I have been associated for more than 15 years with SIPET, Guindy in Chennai, where all the engineering graduates used to really come and see that whatever the plastic waste which we are really collecting as a solid waste in the municipal waste and how it can be really converted into consumer products, again, it was not spoiling to really our climate change. And if you, first of all, I would like to really present the scenario of our waste generation. If you really see the cities, I have really gone through your, you know, Central Pollution Control Board statistics, what has been recently done. On an average, if you really take our Chennai, and we are generating more than 5,000 metric tons of waste every day. And if you take all 31 states in India, and on an average, nearly 9,000 metric tons of waste is really being generated, out of which 7 to 10% is really plastic waste, depending on the consumption pattern of the concerned state. And the real problem, the real challenge here is there is not 100% collection of the solid waste. Only 60 to 70%, or I would even say that 50 to 60% is really being collected. So what is happening to the remaining 50%? That 40% of this, you know, plastic waste remain uncollected. So it is really spoiling an ugly scene. Therefore, our Honorable Prime Minister of India, when he was launching day before yesterday during the Gandhi Jayanti day, our dream is to we have garbage free, and which is really spoiling the beauty of our roads and then our city and our India. So even 40% is not collected, and whatever we have collected, it's only 9 to 10% is recycled, and the other thing is going to the landfill. And if you really see, we have really seen in our solid waste collection, 94% of the total waste what we are collecting is thermoplastic, which is really recyclable. And the remaining belongs to the family of thermoset, which is not recyclable. So now, you know, if you really see that, is all the problem, all of us know, those who are really working in solid waste management. But how can we really achieve? Number one is, when you are really requested as students and then the manufacturers and the collectors and all these people, I think we need to really ensure 100% collection of all the waste. Then only we could really achieve all these, you know, amendment rules, so that, you know, we could really recycle all the plastic waste what we are really collecting it. And we need to really have a, if you really see our, all the rules and everything, the urban bodies, local bodies, and then also the individual players, those who are really playing solid waste management, they have to establish a material recovery center by the local body. If you really see our management rules, MSW, storing waste at home is the primary responsibility of each and every citizen. It is not a throwaway culture. And then we need to segregate our waste at source. Very often we always say that, how can we really segregate? All of us are office going people, we have no time. My simple answer is, don't mix it. If you mix it only, then you have to segregate it. If you see our anatomy, even if you see our open defecation in our anatomy, the urination is in the front side and the fecal material is at the back. That's how in our whole anatomy is designed. But when we go to the toilet, we mix up everything and then we go to the wastewater recycling and start recycling it. Is it how fair it is, you know, that, you know, we can really do this kind of, you know, mixing and then so then segregating it, then finding a solution in. I think our solution should really start from the level when we are really start, you know, generating our waste. My waste is my responsibility. When I really start, you know, in all our culture, throwaway culture, I do not know how we have really adopted this culture. 30 years back, we have not really, I have traveled all over the globe. I have never taken my, you know, water bottle to drink my water. But now, we are not really confident to really take water from the tap. This is the mental block we have, you know, with our thing. Therefore, processing of the waste using appropriate technology, I think, you know, I would like to really show some of our, you know, members. Recently, we have launched Waste to Wealth Club. So everybody sees by segregating it, what is it I'm getting it? Yes. We need to really have appropriate technology. At the same time, you can make your business also. I always say that garbage is nobody's business, but I want to make this as everybody's business. Unless each and every one of us, it is not corporate social responsibility, but it is citizen social responsibility. All of us have to really take part in this, you know, processing and segregating waste so that we can really have a dream of our Bapuji and our Honorable Prime Minister who has really dreamt clean India. And I'm so happy that Sipat Bhopal has really organized this wonderful seminar highlighting all the rules and regulations and what we should do. I am at the ground level for the last 30 years so that I would like to really share with you how we can really mitigate this thing. Unless and otherwise 100% collection is there, still, you know, we will have lot of things, you know, uncollected, and that will be spoiling our, you know, mother nature and environment. I just want to show you our, you know, some of the things, what we do it. It has to be collected in a segregated manner. For that, our people have to really have it. In many cities, I have seen people segregated, but there is only one compactor, because we have to really take it to the landfill. So therefore, you know, they want to really put everything together and then take it to the landfill. So in that way, how do we really recover the plastic, you know, resources? So we need to have two bins. So we need to really go for a low-cost solution. And if you really segregate it at source and then take it like that, then, you know, there is no need for you to sit like this and then start segregating it. And we always make people, we bring all the unsegregated material and make people to really, you know, start, you know, segregating it. Once we segregate it, see in our area, how we really segregate it, plastic bottles, PET bottles, MLPs and everything, it has to be segregated in a nice manner and then we bundle it like this. Then your, you know, raw material is ready for you to really process your material. And then, you know, this is one of our, you know, member who is really doing it, Central Reserve Police in Avadi Station, where, you know, how the organic waste is really separated and how all the other, you know, plastic waste is really segregated and then put into nice bags. And they are using it for road laying purpose. And this is an approved technology by, like, Professor Vasudevan of Madurai Tyagaraja College, and he's the Padma Shri Dr. Vasudevan, and he is just using this technology. And then, you know, we have lots of, you know, waste to energy projects. And in the waste to energy projects, it is not really, you know, here, you know, we are just having our, you know, food waste to really, you know, digest it in a digester. And then, you know, providing electricity to our, you know, municipality. If every municipality and urban bodies and local bodies it could do it, then there is no need for us, you know, to really see waste as a waste and plastic as a nuisance and plastic is really polluting the nature. And then if you really see our, you know, all these things, this, you know, we had done it with the SIPET. When we started our initiative way back in 2000, with SIPET, we had really ground those pellets. And then, you know, we have used it, you know, for, you know, research purpose with the help of the SIPET in Chennai. Many of the engineering students have really started that business. So if this is only possible if all 100% waste is collected in the field. If 40% is remaining uncollected, again, we will really having a very, very, you know, unclean atmosphere and everything. This, you are seeing this is the CLIN. It's an approved technology and it's a pyrolysis method. And then, you know, we are just using it as a charcoal and which you could really use it in the industrial boiler. And these are all the some of the initiatives. I'm just showing some of the photographs so that each photograph will really one is equivalent to 1,000 words what we are speaking. And many places, the stormwater drains, which are really, you know, laid down in urban local bodies, it is not covered. The office-going people, they just threw away mixed waste. And then, you know, many of the, out of this 40% uncollected, 10% is all coming from this nallas. And that kind of a thing, we just use it in the stretch machine. And it is again an approved technology from the Central Pollution Control Board. And then, you know, the emission level, you know, really coming, it's a white gas, which is really approved. And the residue is the ash, which is a ceramic ash, which we can really use it, you know, for our this thing. So these are all some of the things. Now, you know, just last week, one of our members, 1,000 carry bags, he has just taken and she has made into a stool. So these are all some of the initiatives, you know, which we can really, you know, do it. For these things, you know, what we note, second Azadi ka Andolan. अगर ये आजादी के आंदोलन में सब लोगों की पार्टिसिपेशन होना चाहिए, एवरी स्टेक होल्डर हैज टू पार्टिसिपेट इन इट, वेदर द स्टूडेंट फ्रटर्निटी और द यूनिवर्सिटी फ्रटर्निटी, प्रोफेसर और सॉलिड वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट एक्टर्स इन द फील्ड और अर्बन बॉडी और लोकल बॉडी, वॉट एवर इट इज, इफ यू हैव टू रियली मेक अवर यू नो दिस प्लास्टिक मैनेजमेंट रूल्स, the amendment rules since 2016 till now, if you want to really make this as a implementable at the local, at the field level, I think, you know, we need to have a participation by all the people. We always say information, education and communication. We need to give a proper information and we need to educate the public and we need to communicate in a simple thing. In my plating, the last woman in the society, she should be our, you know, informal sector people should really understand. This cannot be achieved by only one speaker announcement or one auto announcement. It is like drinking coffee and tea in the morning. It has to really form a habit. This habit will be done only repeatedly, repeatedly. We need to really enforce this in the mind so that, you know, it has to be a continuous sustainable quality wise product, because nowadays in this COVID-19 situation and nobody is really coming out, and then, you know, there is a lot of vendors and everything, you know, they are just shouting with all the vegetable names and everything. With that thing, if you also really announce this kind of a rule, how to really segregate, how to really, you know, keep it at home and who will come and take it, all these things really need a lot of effort, and it has to be a continuous effort, continuous concerted quality effort. This can be, can really start it from the school level, from the university level, so that everybody has to really part. So this is a KAP, knowledge, attitude and practice. Unless we really remove our mental block from the throwaway culture to really process culture, because whenever we talk about solid waste management, फेंकना है कचरे को, फेंकना है और कूड़े को फेंकना है. क्यों फेंकना है? कि फेंकने के अलावा उसको प्रोसेस करना है, बिकॉज ऑल दीज थिंग, देर शुड नॉट बी एनी लैंडफिल. देर इज वाई यू नो वी थॉट दैट वी नीड टू हैव एन अप्रोप्रिएट टेक्नोलॉजी. आई एम वेरी वेरी हैप्पी दैट आवर यू नो सिपट हैज रियली कम फॉरवर्ड टू रियली सेलिब्रेट आजादी का अमृत महोत्सव, एंड विथ ऑल दीज टेक्नोलॉजीज we will really have clean India, which is our dream. And I have really shared some of my humble experiences, what we have been doing it. See, now, you know, what we have done is, from this single-use plastic, we make very sure that we don't really make it as a throwaway thing. Our all these things, what we are using it, 75 microns, and we are weaving it and we are making into handloom products, and we are giving livelihoods to the people. And this is how, you know, the circular economy is being built. From the waste, we are really going to the thing, giving to the livelihoods to all the people, and then, you know, we are making a clean economy. Whatever the technology which we are using it, we are not using any external energy. We are using it with the hand woven product, so that no energy consumption is there, so that our quality is really maintained. So this is a kind of humble expression, experiences, and the bottlenecks what I have been facing it, and I would like to share in this platform so that all the other solid waste management field operators could also really come into a different kind of, you know, alternatives, so that single use plastic can be banned and the other plastics, you know, how it could be really reused, which is a working model which we have really shown it. And then we have really made many of our interns, and we have an incubating center with the help of our, you know, Sipat, Windy, Chennai. They come and then they really take part in it. So thank you very much for the wonderful opportunity Sipat Bhopal has given to me. to share our humble experiences in the field, because there can be many rules, there can be many things, unless and otherwise, because this is not a plastic waste management, it is not separately being done, it is along with the solid waste. And with the solid waste, if you could really practice it, it has to be, the mantra is segregation at source. We always say, jati ko humko baantna nahi chahiye, aur hamara language ko baantna nahi chahiye, aur hum kahan se aate hain usko baantna nahi chahiye. Ek hi hai hamare baat, wo hai hamare koode ko baantna hai. अगर कूड़े को अच्छी तरह बांट के रखने से ही हम उसको रिसाइकल और अपसाइकल और सर्कुलर इकोनॉमी के लिए हम एक कंट्रीब्यूट कर सकते हैं. धन्यवाद.
थैंक यू मैडम फॉर योर वेल एक्सप्लेन एंड लाइवली डेमोंस्ट्रेशन स्पेशली about your work or about your organization culture, and a lot of people are going to take, definitely I assure you, a lot of initiative with your this noble words. And as earlier, I just wanted to inform that madam has got the award of servant of the poor. So definitely she is also involved in that type of work where many people does not even want to see her. So that type of environment conditions she is, day-to-day life she is spending. So thank you very much, madam. And any question, definitely question-answer session. If few people are asking, so please be on the line with us and continue. So now I request Dr. P. Parthasarathy, who is Managing Director from E. Parsia Private Limited, Bengaluru. Sri Parthasarathy is a B.Tech from AC College of Technology, University of Madras, now it is Chennai. MSc in Chemical Technology Engineering from IIT Chennai in 81, and PhD in Earth Science and Resource Management from Karnataka. And he has got a lot of awards, National Award level in 2017 for 7th National Award for Technology Innovation, similar 2010 Outstanding Entrepreneurship, then MSME Project Award and some Glory India Award. And he has adopted the best techniques in his career, especially in their organization, the cleaner technology, and to implement 3R best practices. And I request Dr. Parthasarathy to start with his presentation on e-based practices of plastic. Dr. Parthasarathy, please.
Jain sir, Principal Director of CIPET Bhopal. Namaskar. Again, our association with CIPET goes back more than a decade this. And the earlier director general was personally involved in some of the projects connected with e-waste, in which we are also been an industrial partner. And he used to visit us also quite often for the review meetings and all that. So with this introduction, I would like to start this, what we do with the electronic waste, and particularly the plastics from the electronic waste, which are mostly engineering plastics. Most of it are recyclable into other products. So, and our project is located at yeah, is it okay? The slides are clear. Hello.
Yes. Yes.
Can I go ahead? Yeah.
Yeah.
So I would like to say, first of all, e-waste is not at all a waste. It is
no,
not at
all slide show. I also say not slide show. You can
slide show, yeah. Yeah, it's slide show. Slide show. Is it okay? Is moving? Moving now?
Okay.
Okay. Yeah, it's a resource. E-waste is a resource. It's full of resource of metals and plastics, various plastics and even glass. And this is what I am just going to present in that. And, you know, this is a project which we started way back in the year 2004. Before that, I was associated with a Singapore-based recycler who was mainly the recycling electronic products and components, mainly from the factories. It's a process waste, not the product waste anyway. After that, I started this Parisara in near Bangalore. It's about 50 kilometers away. And that time, the government said I should start close to the scientific landfill, TSDF, which was much later it came up, thinking that most of the e-waste will go to the landfill. But now the whole thing has been reversed. Ours is almost zero landfill. We have not done any landfill for the past few years. Most of it is successfully recycled into other products or even energy recovery and all that. So also, from the beginning, there is no foreign technology or anything. Ours has been totally made in India and made in India. We developed many processes, many machineries also, and some of them we have published and also some patents. So from the beginning, it has been a Swachh Bharat mission on. Yeah, coming to this e-waste, now they are coming into the circular economy because of the various resources of metals and plastics and even glass, which mainly contributes to for the economics, means the values from that, and also the environmental impacts, and also social impacts in terms of employment, direct and indirect. So this has been a model which we developed the first time in India. Another thing is the benefits of the recycling. When you recycle metals or plastics, most of the energy requirements are drastically reduced. Even the water consumption is reduced, and reduced the pollution of air, water, and even soil. And some of the examples are given here, most of these from the United Nations, UNEP data. And so therefore, one should always think of recycling. And one good example is, if one ton of paper is recycled, we are almost saving 17 fully grown trees. That is one example. Yeah. So coming to the problems of e-waste, it's always been the informal sector because there is a lot of value in that. And we have personally studied Parisara, Bangalore, as well as Chennai. And of course, other NGOs study what is happening in the other cities like Delhi, Calcutta, and Bombay, also Mumbai. So the main problem is the informal sector doing hazardous operations of burning and all that to recover the metals and valuables. And some many cases, they have been using child labor earlier, but by and large now it is controlled because it is prohibited now. So, but the problem is their recoveries are inefficient, and also they unknowingly or unscientific processing they do, causing the environmental damage of air pollution, water pollution. And a lot of studies have been taking place, some of these pictures, and especially this is the belt east of Delhi, Ghaziabad and Moradabad, Meerut and Rampur. And the government also appointed a panel committee, and they went into the detail. And this is one picture, you see a child is washing the circuit boards in the river, sorry, Ram Ganga, near Moradabad. And these are all the plastics, Bangalore. This is Bangalore only. Our team only took these pictures. But then here there is nothing hazardous because they segregate the plastic and most of it gets recycled. So there's no problem. So coming to the e-waste, the government of India brought the e-waste rules in the year 2016. And again, here also the amendment was brought in the year 2018. Here they have set the targets also for the producers, manufacturers, how much should be collected. And because of the COVID, these targets are also reduced. And the DROs have been appointed, the producer responsible organizations for e-waste collection, mainly from the consumers as well as from the informal sector, so that it is properly channeled to the approved recyclers. So this amendment also came in the year 2018, just like the plastic waste management rules, which brought in 2016, and Dr. Sandesh Kumar has already mentioned that three amendments, and he went into the details. So I would prefer to skip all these sides on the plastic waste management rules, since it has been dealt in detail by the earlier speaker, Dr. Sandesh Kumar. And even the latest amendment, I think he has also gone into the details of that, why the 75 microns is now, and then it is going to be 120 in the next year. Okay. So earlier, we used to call this whole plastic waste management rule, when it was brought in 2016, as a carry bag rule, because it was mainly dealing with the carry bags only. Of course, later on, they have added many other things, which earlier speakers have already highlighted, and how it is being dealt in that, and also the quantification, how much is that it is given 34 lakhs. 69,000 tons, which is almost comes to 10,000 tons per day. So, but then we, do you see them here? Where is that? Is it all collected to one place? That's the biggest challenge. The challenge is, where is it? We have the quantities, we have the inventory, we don't disprove, but same thing, e-waste also, they call it 3 million tons, but where is the 3 million tons? We are starving for the material. We are not getting, because of several reasons of our culture. In when it comes to electronic waste, it is a no-throw culture. We don't throw them. We just keep them in the house for many years. I know some people who have been keeping the old transistors and even VCRs, PCPs. They have not been returned back and into the recycling chain. And this is where the producer responsibility comes into picture. EPR, we call it extended producer responsibility, because even in the case of plastics, we know who are the major plastic manufacturers in our country and what is it really happening. What is their responsibility there? These questions remain, because we can't just blame only the public, because by increasing from 20 micron to 120 microns now, it is only going to benefit some of the manufacturers. And what is their role in take back or in recycling? It's a big question, right? Yeah. Now, coming to the e-parisara, we started with a small facility, which I said 50 kilometers away from the city of Bangalore. I was asked to set it up next to the landfill, but then there is no landfill now. Most of it we approved that can be successfully recycled with our own data. And gradually we increased our capacity, and even now we are running only on one shift only. And most of our employees, workforce, are from the surrounding villages. There is no employment from other states or anything. So we didn't have this problem what was raised recently during COVID. So, and of course, we have also implemented a lot of COVID protocols in our facility. Yeah. Yeah. This is the dismantling, and you can see. And you see a lot of plastics, especially here, the keyboards, most of them are HIP. And these are all dismantled by the who are skilled right now. In fact, they know how to identify the plastic and how to segregate it. And this is the picture of that. And another picture. And this is what we have done after pandemic. This is after pandemic, social distancing and all that. So we made the cubicles kind of a thing so that the COVID protocols are maintained. So these people, after dismantling, they segregate. They segregate most of it at source itself. Various types of plastics are segregated. various metal containing materials are segregated. And sometimes the material may need further dismantling, that is also segregated. Yeah, this is the characterization of e-waste, and this is most of the e-waste in India, what we are getting in our facilities. 75% is the computers, and 13% telecom is not the mobile phone. We are not at all getting mobile phone. There are various reasons can be attributed for why we are not getting. But what you see this figure is the back end of the mobile phones, the servers and routers, mainly, as you know, from 3G to 4G, now 4G to 5G, there is going to be a lot of obsolescence of equipment. So this is the incoming whatever figures, and the outgoing characteristics, the plastics are almost one third is the plastics. Most of them are engineering plastics and which can be easily recycled. And of course, we have various metals, including precious metal, gold, silver, palladium, platinum. Most of it we are also trying to recover. And you see this mild steel chassis, and the cabinets are all compacted, baled, and do this. And then it goes for melting in the surrounding Bangalore industrial areas, where it converted into tar steel because the demand for tar steel is so high in the construction industry. Also, we do the recovery of aluminum, copper, brass, and this is our specialty from the beginning. We have been recovering the visible gold, the gold which is visible to our naked eye. We have been recovering and reuse them in the electroplating of various components, watches, and pens, and temple items, even the gods. We do the plating of gold and silver. And this is all we have proven already, because there was a project in which former director general was the chairman of the committee. And we have proved that we have the indigenous capability of recovering gold, silver, palladium, and copper, and all that. And not only that, we also done the platinum, indium, tantalum, selenium. All this we have recovered. And this was also demonstrated to NITI Aayog, Dr. Saraswat, when he visited our facility. Yeah, when you coming to plastics, most of the plastics are dismantled, segregated, and we are... this side shows the benefit of recycling the plastics, especially the engineering plastics. This is the data from, again, UNEP. And you can see how much of water saving, energy saving. And indirectly, we're saying the crude and the petroleum, because most of the plastics, the origin is from the crude only. Yeah. So this is a different varieties of plastics used in the, especially computers, you see, and the display devices. And this has been studied in detail. And there also was a project with Afshipet, in which we were also associated in the Bhuvaneshwar LRPM facility. And there have been some student projects also, PhD projects. And this is all our studies, what we have done, and with our materials, the characterization of different plastics, what we have done here. And if you see this, ABS is the main, and then the acrylic. This is mainly from the LCD screen, and most of it is successfully gets recycled. Typically, of course, the plastics are all first shredded and ground. After grinding, the cleaning, and then they mix the dye colors, and then extrude it. It's a thermal reform, extrude into pellets, granules, and then it makes into another product. So some of these products, using our own material, it's all carried out in Bangalore only into another product. You can see the switch plates, and this is the voltage stabilizer box, all made from the recycled e-waste plastics. And this is the project which I was talking about with the LRPM, and where the study was done scientifically, and then they proved that by recycling the e-waste plastic into an electronic meter cover, which they have made, and this was studied in detail, and they have shown that the cost reduction can be as much as plus about 300%. Yeah, this is all the methodology, how they are developed by from the master batch. And this is the 83% cost saving compared to using a virgin plastic. This is the outcome of the project done by Cipetron. And we also developed jointly with the CII and Swiss NGO how to identify different plastic using simple methods, not using this FTIR or expensive equipment, which many people cannot afford to have because they cost a huge capital investment. So the simple methods of identifying and segregation was also developed jointly by CII and Hyderabad unit as well as the Swiss NGO. Yeah. And this is being practiced also. And this is some of the studies, mainly R&D, especially IWA when the solid waste management rules came into picture, I was asked to do, because originally this was developed for circuit board pyrolysis. But later on, when the circuit board project took another direction of smelting, direct smelting, so we used this equipment to study the various plastic waste like Kurkure wrappers, that is the multiple wrappers, and thermocol, and the PUF, puff, that the polyurethane foam plastics, and also now the end-of-life solar panels, PV panels, photovoltaic panels. Also, we are studying the pyrolysis by using homemade. It's all fabricated locally and being studied also. We have also done DSC and TGA of these fuels obtained from these plastics. See, the other main problem of e-waste is the wire and cables burning and by informal sector, because that is a very easy, simple way of recovering valuable copper, and the copper price has gone up probably twice over the past 2 years. And you see, this is the equipment where the wire and cable can be shredded, and you can separate the insulation layer, which is mainly PVC, and recover almost 99% pure copper. This is all the locally developed machineries. This is the circuit board smelting machine, which I earlier mentioned. We have developed completely indigenous and homemade. In fact, we have fabricated everything in-house, including the control panel. There was a monitoring committee. Recently, the project also got concluded. Now we are in the implementing stage now. The glass from CRT also been recycled. This is again closing the loop, circular economy. We have been sending to Videocon, but nowadays is mostly replaced by LCDs. That also we have solved the complete problem. And this is the lamp waste, mainly the tube lights and CFLs, which we are also established, homemade, complete, made in India, zero effect and zero defect, all those things we have done much earlier. And we also demonstrated that using this glass, we can make bangles. This was all made in Karnataka only. Yeah, otherwise, we have been sending it to the glass clusters in Hirosaba. This is our new facility in Andhra Pradesh. It's about 90 kilometers across the border from Bangalore. This facility, we have started recycling lithium-ion batteries, mainly from mobile phones and laptops, and off late even the EV batteries, end-of-life EV batteries. So this has been also been established. And we have two wings. One wing is mainly e-waste only, the regular e-waste which I have been talking. The other wing is for the lithium-ion battery recycling. In this facility, we have also done a unique thing, which is again Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. The end-of-life panels, solar panels, photovoltaic panels, we made the toilets out of them. And toilets as well as the wash and the restroom facility. And of late, we have also done a canteen block completely with the end-of-life PV panels. And in fact, the government has constituted a committee for PV panel recycling funded by Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, MeITY, and the project is being carried out by CMET, Hyderabad, and I am also a member of that. In fact, I am the chairman of that committee for end-of-life TV recycling. So these are all our environment, health and safety initiative, because we work with the major MNCs and corporates, and they expect high standard of operations, and not just the government pollution board certificate, because we have to go through audit protocols. Even today, there is an audit going on by a multinational company. So we need to have high quality of recycling standards and material flow and how it is all handled and the material balance. In that process only, we have all the certification. We also certified a Green Co company by the CII with a gold standard. And we have also done a lot of publications. And this this publication is mainly on this recycling of engineering plastic from e-waste recycling, and also a patent for recovery of copper thin wires. This is a thin wire plastic. In fact, for this invention only, CIPET has gave me an award. Thank you very much again, and I was honored to get the award from the former late minister. Mr. Anand Kumar Ji, yeah, thank you once again. I was also inspired by none other than our former president of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. When he visited our stall on an environment day, that was 666, 6th of June 2006, and we had a good interaction and discussion. He appreciated our approach. That is the inspiration for us. Yeah, this is all the awards. This is the one I was just mentioning, the CIPET award I could receive from, unfortunately, it's no more late. And Kumasi, thank you once again, CIPET. And we can always say that e-waste not just necessarily should be recycled. We have several ways of reuse. And in fact, very recently, they have also made junk jewelry. The jewelry made up of e-waste components, various imitation jewelry they call. I mean, I call it the junk jewelry. And even the waste coming from the cartoons and the manuals and operating books and all that manuals, we have been recycling that into useful files and bags and even writing pads. With the but then you can always think of using in a different way, like this leather parts, pen stand, and things like that. And this is the Diya lamps were done with Art of Living for a Diwali festival. And I would like to say that one should not look down on the plastic, ban plastic. No, we cannot ban plastic. We have to live with it. The problem of the plastic is our littering habit. We throw them, we litter them. Of course, municipal solid waste rules came, and Madam Dr. Mangalam Balasubramaniam also gave a lot of thoughts into the municipal solid waste management. But we call it the door-to-door collection. But then we have to do road-to-road search for the collector, because they don't come. It keeps lying. I tried segregation and giving them, but then they mix it into all in one bin. These are all the problems. It's complex thing, and they also need to be educated. And they all chase for the values again. Okay. They'll be happy to see a computer or a laptop in a municipal solid waste throw, but then that doesn't happen in our country. So the value-based recycling is very important, because even the rag pickers or the municipal waste collectors, they look for the valuables. They look for glass bottles, they look for PET bottles, and when it comes to no value, it is neglected. That is the scenario, the real scenario in India, which we need to look into it in the future. Probably further amendments also will come into picture. And in addition to the EPR, which I talked about, the producer responsibility, because we don't find much of a role from this large plastic manufacturer whose name I'm unable to mention at the moment in this program, but we all know who are. Okay. So their roles is also important in take back and recycling. Thank you very much. Thank you. Namaskar.
So, thank you.
Dr. Rajesh, Dr. Sandesh Kumarji, I have another meeting coming up. Okay. So can you please excuse me? And any questions you may forward to me later. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Thank you. Thank you.
So thank you, Dr. Parsathi. Actually, he has also pointed out few things which is we have never thought of. The electronic waste can be used for some items in household also. So that thing he has raised. And ultimately, plastic is not waste. It is the material which is, because of our littering habits and other improper way of organizing our own system, is creating few issues. So with this note, I now invite Mr. Rajesh Kumar Saxena ji, who is Superintendent Engineer in Municipal Corporation Bhopal, the key person for handling Swachh Bharat Mission and Bhopal City, for his views on plastic waste management and best practice. So, Rajesh Kumar Saxena ji, please.
Good afternoon to everyone. I'd like to excuse everyone for the inconvenience caused, because Mr. Saxena sir is attending a conference with CEO Smart City and BCLL. So he'll not be present at the moment. And so I'll be representing him for the same topic. I'm Saurabh Sood, Assistant Engineer in Swachh Bharat Mission for Bhopal Municipal Corporation. And I'll be seeking the presentation forward for the same topic. So can you please allow me to, can I be presenting the presentation for the same? Hello, sir. Can I give the presentation on his behalf?
Mr. Saxena ke behalf par?
Mr. Saxena sir is busy with CEO sir right now. So he has told me to start the presentation. He will be joining.
Please, start again, please. You have a good name.
Thank you, sir. My good name is Saurabh Sood, and I am Assistant Engineer in Swachh Bharat Mission for Bhopal Municipal Corporation. I'll be starting the presentation he made for the plastic waste management and the best practices adopted in Bhopal City. So here's the slide we are sharing with you. First of all, I'd like to tell you about the city. Bhopal is the cleanest capital, which has been awarded for the 4 times continuously in a row in the surveys. Being the cleanest capital, we feel proud of our city, and we have made the practices for the same, for the plastic waste management in the city. Like the concept goes for the 3R, that is recycle, reduce and reuse. We have done following major steps has been taken from our side for the practicing the solid waste management and plastic waste management there. As you can see, it's a brief description of about our city. Our city is consisting of 19 zones made up of 85 wards.
आपका कुछ प्रेजेंटेशन दिखाई नहीं दे रहा है.
ओके शेयर.
इफ यू आर नॉट एबल टू शेयर देन प्लीज शेयर. आपका पीडीएफ, इट इज पीडीएफ और पीपीटी?
इट्स अ पीपीटी सर.
बट आई डोंट नो इट इज कन्वर्टिंग टू पीडीएफ. स्क्रीन शेयर करिए, स्क्रीन शेयर बोले दिखाई दे, नॉट गोइंग टू यूज देम, कंप्लीट स्क्रीन शेयर फर्स्ट ऑप्शन से आता है उसमें. Now it's better, I hope so. Right.
Okay, sir.
Full screen. This slide show.
Is it visible now, sir?
You can do slides, so you have done, na? Is you go slides show kari hai?
Yes, sir.
Achali, visible hai. Ab aap dikhaiye.
Sir, the all of we know that Bhopal is spread according in the vast area of 417 square kilometers. It is divided into 19 zones consisting of 85 wards. So the population here is about 23 lakhs and the total waste generated is about 877 tons per day. The dry waste consists of 446 tons per day and the wet waste is about 430 tons per day. So the major sources of waste we have identified is from the residential area, from commercial area, from institutional area, and like from the municipal services. So in the residential area, the components of solid waste is food waste, green waste, dry waste, sanitary waste, and domestic hazardous waste. Same in the commercial and institutional and municipal services, the components of solid waste are mentioned here. So basically, in the previous topics, the conditions of plastic waste management rules 2016 and amendments in the 2020 and 21 rules have already been discussed, so I'll like to forward it and discuss about the work done by the Bhopal Municipal Corporation to stop single-use plastic waste. First of all, in the ULB, we have decided to implement the fine and penalties for the use of single-use plastic. For that, we have done the seizing from the market. Like we all know that the door-to-door and the commercial shops are using the less micron sizes polythenes in the market, and it is easily available to the customers who are not carrying their bags. So the plastic polythenes are seized from that shopkeepers, and for after seizing, this practice is adopted. Also, we also distribute the cloth bags to prevent use of plastic bags. We also deployed NGOs for creating awareness in the people to use cloth bags. Like we all do, we deploy the NGOs and we create awareness among the people roaming around the commercial areas caring to use and promote the cloth bags. Also, we took an initiative for using the wedding to use the promotion and encouragement of Bartan Bank in the Bhopal Municipal Corporation areas. In the wedding party, you know, the plastic crockeries were used. We encourage them to use the Bartan Bank and to take the utensils from that. We also encourage the people to use alternative of plastic bag, that is paper bags, cloth bags. And we already had a good monitoring system to monitor about the practices for the avoiding of single-use plastic areas. We aware the community through advertisement and banners also. As you can see, the spot fines and activities done by BMC to stop use of carry bags. The number of spot fines were about 6,851, which are huge in quantity. We seized about 5902 kilograms of polythene from the markets, which were not up to the mark. And we spotted the fines over them. And the collected revenue from that was about 12,93,110 rupees. As you can see the photographs, how we encourage the use of paper bags and cloth bags. Like here, you can see on the left-hand side, we promoted and we made a oath from the citizens to promote the cloth bags instead of plastic bags. We distributed cloth bags to the self-help groups of the Bhopal area to promote cloth bags. From community level to even the door-to-door level, we promoted the awareness of using cloth bags instead of plastic bags. Here you can see the plastic crockery which was used in the marriages were replaced by the bartan bag utensils. Here you can see the steel utensils. They were shared with the persons who were in the engagement or any kind of wedding anniversary or any else anniversary. They were shared the utensils, and instead of plastic bags, the steel utensils were used in the bartan, from the bartan bank. This you can see that the plastic bags, the plastic polythenes which were seized from the market, which were of less than size of 50 microns. So from the local thela walas and the other parties which were using that were fined, and the seized plastics were being recovered from them. This is one of a unique idea that Bhopal Municipal Corporation started, that is carry your own bag. CYOB concept was being highly appreciated by the higher authorities from the government agencies. Carry your own bag was the concept where the use of plastic bag was abandoned, and we promoted to CYOB, that is carry your own bag. Whenever you go to buy something, whenever you go to market, whenever you go to any commercial area, you carry your own bag from the household only. And this was also implemented that the self-help groups and the other women were making cloth bags from the clothes so that they can be encouraging the cloth bags. This you can see that we promoted eco-friendly bartans, that is dona patal, which were back when we rewind ourselves, that the dona patals was the tradition of Indian culture wedding. The dona patals were used for the sharing of meals and other things. We have promoted that also, that it can be used and it can be recycled very easily rather than plastics. So these are the three kind of photographs which you can see. The one woman which is handling her own bag from the carry your own bag concept. We have shared that say no to plastic, and we have advertised and used our kid as a brand ambassadors. As you all know that whenever the youth is involved, whenever the kids are involved, the parents are also being aware, and they also feel encouraged to follow the same practices. This you can see the initiative under 4R activities, that is waste to art. We all know that Bhopal is being called city of lakes. So at the boat club, we installed a waste to globe. It's a kind of world map made. It's a type of globe portrait, which is made up of 15,000 waste plastic bottles. And these are being colored and crafted in such a way that it makes a globe out of it, in which it is about 8 feet of radius, and the total weight of plastics was about 500 kgs. So what we observe here is that we are promoting 4R concept over here, and we are making people aware, whoever visits the boat club, that out of plastic we can make this kind of reuse out of it. And to stop further promotion of plastic and to stop the use of plastic. Also, as a symbolic, the Bhopal Municipal Corporation's logo has been made out of it, in which 10,000 plastic waste bottles were used. And it is the largest logo which was located at ISBT bus stop Bhopal. Also, making out of waste was a very good concept in the Bhopal Municipal Corporation. We made a radio out of it and also a guitar. having a height of 26 feet and weighing about 1250 kgs. Like the earlier orator said about the e-waste reuse, it's a good example of reuse of e-waste, in which keyboards and motherboards and other e-waste were used for the portrait of this guitar. And also the e-waste also was being used in the radio made out of which you can see. This is a kind of cycle that which follows from the source to landfill processing. Thank you for listening such kindly.
Yeah, thank you very much. Mr. Prasad Gopal, official, I think, assistant engineer, sir, on behalf of Mr. Saxena, I sincerely request one more point to you. I am also finding few slides where you are talking, writing same note to plastic. So, being a promotion institute also for plastic and thrive to, I request you can modify. Say no to single-use plastic rather. Okay.
Yes.
So because you start telling no to plastic, then that meaning is slightly different. This is my request.
Surely, sir.
So we can. And it's very nice presentation. You have given the overall scenario of Bhopal city. In fact, but as institute, we are also not aware that so many initiatives has been taken by Bhopal Municipal Corporation. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Now, I am inviting Dr. Syed Asad Ali Warsi, who is environmentalist cum sustainable advisor. Last 26 years, he is attending various areas in the specialization, especially sustainable development, solid waste management, sanitation, urban development planning, industrial planning, environmental management, wastewater management, environmental impact assessment and circular economy and many more. And he is a very key person and key award winner also, especially he associated with Ministry of Environment and Forest for making these rules guidelines in some technical committee, runs in some apex bodies and circular economy and solid waste management and liquid waste. So, and key award winner, especially in ISAP 2019, Yokohama, Japan, as a key speaker also he has attended. So, may I request Dr. Syed Asad Warsi to give his views on plastic waste management, especially the Indore model. Everybody knows in India, Indore is continuously 4 times cleanest city of India. So, Dr. Warsi has play a very vital role to creating such system at Indore with the other higher officials. So, Dr. Warsi, please. Now, forum is open.
Good afternoon. Namaskar, everybody, sir. You are getting my voice clearly, sir? Sir,
we are hearing, sir. We are hearing.
Okay, thank you very much. So, first of all, I want to congratulate CPET Bhopal for organizing such a webinar on such an important topic and enlightening the entire industry, academics, students, everybody about the importance of plastic waste management rules and how it can be utilized at the best. So I'm just starting with my presentation.
Just start showing your sharing, your screen.
Yes.
Yes. Slide show kar rahe. Yes.
Yes, sir. You are visible, sir?
Yes. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So basically, sir, if we really want to manage this municipal waste and solid waste, it is very, very important that we have to come up with an integrated plan for if we take up any city or any state. Particularly, I'm talking of this urban areas of India. So it is very, very important to come up with a comprehensive integrated solid waste management. And the basic thought behind it should be that how we can convert waste into resource, as very rightly said by Mrs. Bala Subramaniam and Dr. Parsarthi sir and the team from Bhopal Municipal Corporation, that the key to waste management is segregation. And if we are able to segregate the waste at source, that is the key. And if we segregate it into proper manner, we can convert the entire waste into resource, including plastic. As very rightly said, we should not say no to plastic. We have to collect it, we have to segregate it, and we have to showcase the resource value of plastic to everybody by recycling. And that is what we have done in Indore. When we started this project in Indore, everybody used to tell ke bhaiya dekho aap faltu ki baat karte ho, videsh desh ghoome aate ho, hamare log to koi segregate nahi karenge, ye behavior change karna bahut mushkil hai aur log isme cooperate nahi karenge. So important ye hai ki how to develop a model and how to come up with a comprehensive approach. Wahi humne Indore mein kiya. That first of all, we, after making our comprehensive planning and everything, we took it to our political leadership, we took it to the administration, and we told them this is our plan and we need your input how to make it an implementable plan. And then we explained them everything, and our biggest focus was on IEC, that is creating awareness, and public ko isse jodna bahut zaruri tha. That is what we have done. That jitne bhi society ke andar various verticals hain, वो शुरुआत होती है सबसे पहले जो स्कूल गोइंग स्टूडेंट्स है, देन कॉलेज गोइंग स्टूडेंट जितना हमारा यूथ है, देन वेरियस जितने आरडब्ल्यूएस होते हैं, देन मार्केट एसोसिएशन, होटल एसोसिएशन, डॉक्टर्स एसोसिएशन, लॉयर एसोसिएशन. तो हमने एक बहुत ही स्ट्रॉन्ग पूरा कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव अवेयरनेस प्लान बनाया कि कैसे हम इनको अपना पूरा प्लान बताएं, टारगेट बताएं, और ये बताएं कि वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट में सेग्रीगेशन का क्यों इंपॉर्टेंस है. क्योंकि जब तक हर लोग अपने घरों पर, अपने इंस्टीट्यूशन पे, अपने ऑफिस में सोर्स पे वेस्ट को सेग्रीगेट नहीं करेंगे, वी कांट कन्वर्ट इट इनटू बेस्ट रिसोर्स. सो वेस्ट को बेस्ट रिसोर्स में कन्वर्ट करने के लिए इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट वी हैव टू फोकस ऑन सोर्स सेग्रीगेशन, एंड दैट इज वेयर वी फोकस. एंड इन दिस स्लाइड आई एम ट्राइंग टू शो यू व्हाट आर द वेरियस कंपोनेंट्स व्हेन वी टॉक ऑफ इंटीग्रेटेड वेरियस सॉलिड वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट. बिकॉज टुडे आई हैव टू टॉक ऑन दिस प्लास्टिक वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट, एंड आई हैव टू showcase what Indore has done on particularly dry waste and plastic waste management. Today I will be speaking more on that. So basically, when we designed this Indore plan, it was my dream that at least in India we should have a city where we can say that we have 100% soil segregation. In Indore, as we know, Indore is a 3 million plus city. It's have a spread of around 275 square kilometer. We have 85 wards divided into 19 administrative zones. And Indore generates around 1100 to 1200 metric tons of average waste per day. We have around 6 lakh households and around 2 lakh institutions and commercial organizations. So our almost all 8 to 8.5 lakh households and institutions and offices, everybody is segregating waste at source. Initially we started with two, that is dry and waste. And now in the fifth year, we have taken it to 6 bin segregation system. The basic concept of the entire Indore plan was that we have to make city bin free, dust free and litter free. There should not be any secondary garbage collection point or collection bin in the city. That was the basic. We have to establish an effective door-to-door collection system, and the entire vehicle and fleet should be designed in such a manner that it should have various compartments for storing segregated waste, which is being segregated at the household level. Secondly, it is very important that we have to deal with this litter waste. This was the new concept in India, very first time it was launched in India, that we have to make our all roads, our all areas litter free. So for that very reason, we trained our entire staff. What we have done, that we have given training to all the sanitary workers, we call them as Safai Mitras, that while sweeping, after sweeping the entire roads, whatsoever is being allocated to them, they should, we have given them the gunny bags, and we have asked them to collect the entire litter. Apart from sweeping, we will find lot of litters on the footpaths, in green belts, in central wards and all. So we train them to collect the litter, whatsoever is there, be it paper, plastic or glass or metal, whatsoever is there, it has to be collected. And thirdly, it was very important that all the commercial roads, if we want to make our cities livable cities, we have to do carry out mechanical sweeping, and we have to make dust free our all roads. So this is how this entire door to door collection, you can see that green colored compartment is for the organic waste, and dry we have blue. And then this, you can see the third one at the back, that is for the sanitary, that is for the domestic hazardous waste, sanitary waste. And now we have added two more, that is for e-waste, and separate collection of plastic also we have added bins. And now we are collecting in some part of the city dry waste bi-weekly, that is twice a week, so as to reduce the transportation cost also. Again, it is very important that whatsoever plan we make, we have to make it a sustainable and viable plan. So we have to work on economics also, that is very important. So you can see this is how, and for creating awareness and all, we have engaged youths, we have engaged young volunteers on payment basis. They are moving with the vehicle, they are moving in the area, they are moving in the slums, colonies, households, market areas, commercial areas, and they are creating the awareness among the masses for segregation. And that is where for the first 2 years we focused on creating awareness, and that is the key, the awareness on a daily basis. It is not so that we organize just one seminar or so. We have devised our and designed our awareness program in such a way that on a daily basis awareness, some one or two or at least sometimes 10 to 20 awareness programs are taking place in one or other part of the city. So for dry waste, we started with manual material recovery facility, that whatsoever segregated dry waste is collected, we take it to our material recovery facility, then involving all the rag pickers and the workers of municipal corporation, we started segregating various materials, and thereafter we started recycling. So this is what is our initial material recovery facility, which we call as manual material recovery facility, that we bring in the waste, we have a tipping area where we tip the segregated waste, then we sort it and we process it, and then the material is segregated into various fractions, and further it is sent for recycling. You can see this was our initial material recovery facility, wherein we involved all the rag pickers, because rag pickers are the one who understand various materials and the drivers, particularly even the type of plastic when we talk of PP or LD or PET or HDP or multi-layer plastic. So they are the one, because they know it very well, so we engage them and we involve them in the system so as to improve their quality of life and so as to improve their earnings. So this is where we have come up with baling machines, dust removal machines, we call it as in a local language, jhatka phatka machine. Then we have this granulators, wherein we make this plastic pellets, and then we make products out of it. We have this aglo machine and everything. So this is how we developed our initial material recovery facilities. Then we from manual we moved to semi-automatic type of material recovery facilities. So what we did, that whatsoever material is being brought to our tipping floor, we came up with the conveyor belts, and along the conveyor belts we kept various types of containers, and we have trained our all these rag pickers and sanitary workers that a particular rag picker will pick up one type of material, and then it is being collected and stored in these containers, and from there it is sent for making bales and all, and then it is further sent for processing. And this is we have developed the country's biggest ever automated material recovery facility. This the capacity of this plant is around 300 tons per day, wherein the entire dry waste is segregated into 13 various fractions, which are various types of plastics, then paper, rugs, cloth, metal, glass. Metal also we have in this automated material recovery facility. When it comes to metal, we have facility to segregate ferrous as well as non-ferrous material also, particularly aluminium and all. And then the final segregated material is converted and into automated bales, and then these bales are further sent for recycling. Through this material recovery facility, whatsoever dry waste is coming, we are recovering around 25 to 30% as recyclables, and remaining 70% is converted into RDF, that is refuse dry fuel, and that is where we are sending it to cement plants for using it as an alternate fuel. So basically, this is what the entire process is, that from household the material is bought and then it is being recycled and converted into products. So this is what, when we talk of circular economy, as we know that now Government of India, Niti Aayog is coming up with circular economy policy, this is how you can see the segregated material. So we segregate the material, the various type of material in the dry rust, and particularly we have come up, presently we are able to recycle average around out of 300 tons, we are getting around 30 tons of plastic per day, and we are recycling it and we are making various products out of it. So this is how we have trained rag pickers and we involved everybody into our system and our plan. And again, this is what is something very important, that we have improved the livelihood. Initially, when we have started this project, we carried out the survey of all the rag pickers, and then earning was around 100 to 125 rupees per day. So presently, each and every rag picker associated with Indore Municipal Corporation is minimum, they are getting around some 300 to 350 rupees per day. And that has brought in, and because from informal sector, we brought them to formal sector, it has improved their quality of life also and their earnings. Secondly, as very rightly said by Jain sir at the initial level, director at CPET Bhopal, that there are hardly 100 plus organized recycling facilities, plastic recycling facilities are there, and there are more than 10,000 unorganized recycling facilities are there when we talk of throughout the country, all in Madhya Pradesh. So it is very important that now it is high time wherein we have to bring in all this unorganized recycling facility into recycling facility, and then to create inventory so as to have the real-time inventory, and we have to come up with a technological software model or a mobile app wherein we can tap the entire movement of plastic from the generation, how it is being generated from where it is going to segregation centers, from segregation centers it is going to which recycling facility, and then how it is being converted into a product. So if we really are able to come up with a system where we can inventorize the entire plastic in that state, then it will be very easy for us to, on a day-to-day basis, to assess that the quantum of plastic being generated. A ratio can be, we can come up with a ratio, and we can come up with a monitoring mechanism wherein that this, for example, 100 tons of plastic is generated, then how much is being collected and processed. So it is very important and high time wherein we have to come up with such systems. Then again, it is very important to train them, to create IDs for them, to have attendance system, everything. So this is how we have given IDs to all this. We have opened the bank accounts of all the rag pickers. So if we want to come up with a comprehensive system, then it is, this is the bird's eye view of our processing facilities. And even you can see the, in the back side, you can see the legacy waste. This is the old picture of our facility. Now this entire legacy waste also we have treated and we have converted into city forests. This is the view of our material recovery facility. This is how you can see that in our door-to-door collection vehicle, you have seen that we were having the segregated containers. This segregated vehicles containers are being offloaded in our transfer stations, and then through this transfer station also we have color-coded containers. The blue container will carry only dry waste. So this is how we are collecting the entire waste segregated manner at the household level, and we are transporting it, the entire waste, up to the centralized processing facility in segregated manner, and thereafter we are recovering and the material out of it, recyclables. So thank you very much. So these are, this is how, if we come up with a comprehensive plan and approach, then certainly we can convert our waste into resource, and that is what Indore has done. And now after Indore, we are trying that similar type of facilities and similar type of systems can be developed at various cities. Presently we are supporting n number of cities including Bhopal, so as to, because in last 2 years, 2-3 years, Bhopal has also come up And Bhopal have some 3 to 4 decentralized. Now they are also coming up with centralized processing facilities. Similarly, Pune is coming up, Hyderabad is coming up. So there are n number of cities after Indore, because Indore model has proved that yes, in India segregation of waste is possible, and if we segregate the waste in proper manner, we can convert it into resource, and that is what Indore has done. Thank you very much for giving me an opportunity to share the Indore model. Thank you.
Very, very important information which is really useful. And I have seen personally the Indore model once with our DCPC officials also last year. And the best part which he has shown the material segregation, which is they have developed the material recovery facility at different points. And they proved that material can be segregated properly. And the best part, again, I wanted to tell you that the overall transportation cost has also reduced by compressing the similar type of material, and they have transported in the separate transport containers. And another thing which he highlighted regarding livelihoodness of the rag picker, which is very, very important to identify them, and they are balancing their health and their ultimately day-to-day earning. So they have assured that part also. So I also request all our friends who is connected in around bodies and other state people, that something which is really very, very important to create a sustainable model which can be affordable to each government also, rather I can say, so that can be created. Take some advices, take the people who is the front runner, and I hope there may not be any communication gap, and CPAT is there to fill that gap ultimately. So I request Barsi sir that anytime if that type of requirement from some other state people will come, definitely will pass on to you, so you can advise them in a proper way, so that it can be for the national level we can do something better. Now I request a few of the viewers, because time is already over, but still, for if somebody is asking some few questions, we have sent some lines. Few people have asked in online also regarding the rules which is going to be implemented. I think what yesterday 75 micron has been already implemented as per the rule simplifications from yesterday onwards, and 120 micron carry bag I am talking is from 31 December 2022, it is going to be implemented. So this is some information somebody has asked. May I request other people to ask some questions if anybody is interested, to our experts? Anybody? Any student? Some student asked the link, so we have sent. Or you can email and ask the question to us. We can connect to our concerned expert and get the answer. That is another way. If nothing, then I think I sincerely thank all of you and request. Anybody is asking? No. Chat box mein hai. Just check it. Assuming. Any financial assistance for clean technology? So I think Barsi sahab, hello.
Yes sir, under Swachh Bharat mission, various urban local bodies are coming up with this dry waste material recovery facilities. So certainly, if some entrepreneurs are interested, so sometimes depending upon the quantum of waste, the projects are designed on PPP mode, wherein sometimes 100% investment is put by the PPP partner. If it is, if we find that there is some viability gap or funding is required, so various urban local bodies are providing viability gap funding also. And sometimes in the third model, it is happening so that EPC mode, wherein The plant and machinery is established by the urban local body through Swachh Bharat funds, and thereafter it is being given to the companies for running operation and maintenance of the project. So three types of models are there presently working when we talk of this material recovery facilities in our country. And these models, the viability, first of all we have to look into the viabilities. Based on that, various three models are there right now going on, wherein urban local bodies are funding, providing land also sometimes, even sometimes they are providing land and constructing sheds, and so even sometimes they provide machine also. So depending on the quantum of this type of system is there, wherein urban local bodies are supporting young startups and entrepreneurs if they want to come up and support urban local bodies for establishing and running material recovery facilities. Thank you.
I further request the concerned students or stakeholders, other stakeholders who are already in the line for recycling, especially some chemical recycling also. So they can question in through mail, we will connect to the right source. Okay. So thank you once again to all the faculty who is connected. I request Dr. Sanjeev Jain to summarize and give you the book of things.
Thank you, sir. Good afternoon to all of you. Today we have come to now end up this webinar. And we are aware that today this webinar was on plastic waste management and 2021 and its application. So first of all, on behalf of CIPET, I am thankful to our Department of Chemicals and Petrochemicals, our administrative ministry. They have always guided and supported us to celebrate various events of this Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav. We are very thankful for their support and cooperation. Then I am again thankful to Sri P. Naveni sir, IAS, who is Secretary MSCB, Government of Madhya Pradesh. He has given his valuable time for inauguring this webinar, and he has also explained the importance of this plastic waste management and its rules on view of the government and their policies of Madhya Pradesh government. Then I am thankful to our expert speakers, Dr. Mangalam Balasubramaniam, founder and managing trustee of Agnora Green Thermal, Chennai. She has delivered a lecture on solid waste management, and she has very clear cut by showing its granules and everything. She has shown that how this process can be done. I am thankful to her, and I am again thankful to Dr. P. Prasarthi, who has explained about the e-waste management, how the e-waste products can be managed. And then I am also thankful to Sri Rajesh Kumar Saxena, sir. Of course, he was not there. Then Mr. Saurav Sood, who has given presentation on behalf of Mr. Saxena, for showing the Bhopal model of Bhopal Municipal Commission Department, how they are going to waste management at Bhopal city. Again, there is schemes under this Swachhta Mission. They are doing any works that they have shown. Then our last speaker, Dr. Syed Al-Warsi, who is, as already sir has explained, that he is the consultant to the Indore Municipal Corporation, who is one of the best, one of the municipal officers who has got the best award two times. And his presentation was really very inspiring. And we personally, myself and Dr. Sanjay Jain sir, we have seen in Indore personally how the things are going on. So that was really a remarkable presentation, and the message what has been given by Dr. Warsi, that will be beneficial to all the participants and persons from other cities also. And lastly, I'm also thankful to the NIC for providing us this platform for arranging this webinar. And last but not least, I'm also thankful to my principal doctor, Dr. Sanjay Swarjan sir, who has guided us to organize this program, and my entire team who is associated for this webinar, directly or indirectly. I'm thankful to all of them. Thank you very much.
So thank you all of you once again, and we will meet regularly for a few more programs so the public can get aware and industry can be benefited with all the implications. And government official, of course, they are the key person to enforce the laws in different cities. Thank you once again, each and every one.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
So we can close now, right? Thank you.